again. The slowly creeping hand of time and its command. Soon enough it comes and settles in its place. Its shadow in my face puts pressure in my day.
Well, good morning from Yo Homestead. I've got the coffee already going. Young Warren's making his as we speak.
Oh, there was quite a bit of electrical activity in the sky last night. So we thought of, instead of deploying awnings, we might as well utilise the bloody veranda of Yo Homestead itself.
Well, 8:15 in the morning, it's not a bad time to get on the road. What day are we on? 1, 2, this must be day 4. Just departing Yo Homestead, heading east along the Amberdell. So we're going to go about 50 kilometres short of Neil's Junction, and then we're going to turn down an unknown entity called Nary's Point Road. Slowly make our way towards Lake Rosen, about 330 kilometres for the day. Well, poor old Warren's been sucking in my dust for the last 3 days. I thought I'd let him take the lead today. Well, there we have it, Bishop Raleigh's pulpit. Certainly blowing, and as you can see from the sky, it's pretty grey. I think we're going to get some rain today. I don't think we're going to miss out on
Do
that.
Do you have the time to listen to me whine about nothing and everything all at once? I am one of those melodramatic fools, neurotic to the bone, no doubt about it. Sometimes I give myself the creeps. Sometimes my mind plays tricks on me.
I just can't get over after the fires come through how it's cleared up the area so much, and how green it is with the regrowth of the grasses and everything. It's just incredible, so green.
I've got an alarm going off somewhere.
Roger.
One of my tyres.
Well, here we are on the Amberdell. It looks like this is our turn off for Nary's Point Road. Some older maps show Nary's Point Road coming in further up the track, and some of the newer maps doesn't have that at all. But all of them seem to show this Spackman track. It looks like it goes down for about 10 kilometres and then joins up with what we know as Nary's Point Road. It's sort of what I remember. It's looks like it might have a bit of vegetation on it. Alright, so in consultation with Warren, we've decided we're going to plug on down this track. Personally, I think it's going to be a short bit of vegetation and it might clear up a little bit. like I said, about 100 kilometres down to Lake Racen Road, I believe it turns into a track like we've got now, so that would be good. Just depends what this 100 kilometre stretch is like, and there's only one way to find out. We just have to go down and do it, I guess.
Alright, well here goes nothing. Down the Spackman track we go. And I think it changes name to Narry's Point Road a bit further on, but yeah, it looks like it's going to be slow and vegetated for 100 kilometres. That should be fun, hey? So straight in the guts of the Great Victoria Desert. If we had a chance of seeing somebody on the Amberdell, we ain't going to see nobody out here, guaranteed. The Spinifex blind might be in order. Our first diversion. I've had to go and clear some debris out the way so we can get around this tree. Should be alright now. So only a quick diversion. Some big camel prints in the sand here though, I noticed. Not good for tyres driving in this shit, but anyway. That's a big dune up in front. Gotta be 10 to 12 metres in height. I don't think we're going over it. It seems to be that the track seems to be skirting around the ends of them, so we're not actually driving over any dunes, but that is a big dune. Probably the biggest, one of the biggest ones I've seen so far on this trip out in this area. Well, we're about 20 kilometres down the Spackman track now, and we've come across this fire scarred country again, which I thought was going to help with the spin effects, but there's still some big tall seed heads we're ploughing through, so it hasn't helped. Hasn't completely eliminated it, it's probably settled it down a bit.
It all keeps adding up. I think I'm cracking up. Am I just paranoid? Am I just stuck?
We're 30 k's out of 100 k's down, and the Spinifex certainly hasn't got any lighter. We had a quick stop back there to move a tree out the way, but I didn't have a look under mine. I had a look on top. I certainly got lots of Spinifex in nooks and crannies up top. Warren had a look underneath his car, and it's pretty full of spin places. So spin effects is like eye height, and we're obviously just mowing all the seed heads off, and they're just going everywhere. These are only small ones. It's raining, it's pouring. The freaking spin effects is annoying. Well, that camel's a bit on the nose too. Oh, Christ.
Oh well, another obstacle. Another make your own track through the bush. So far you can see, lucky I've got the bug screen on there, that'll be stopping some of it from getting in the radiator. But there's one reason in particular I've stopped, because I've gone and done my usual. I've lost another friggin' tyre. Pain in the arse. That's the shit that'll be mowing down. My plenum chamber's chock-a-block. My air conditioner's not working very well, as you could well imagine. The there's probably a few bloody Spinifex spines in my air filter, even though I've got a gauze on it that's stopped a lot of it. I dread to think what it looks like underneath. Yeah, it's been pretty average. I can see a few bits up there. I don't think it's as bad as Warren's. But anyway, first things first, I have to work out what I'm doing with this tyre. Oh well, here we go, bush mechanics again. Well, it looks like a badly packed kebab, but and it's probably far too late, but got to try and get through. I don't know, I'm about to go check the pressure on this tyre. I don't know if the plugs I've put in is enough to hold it. I don't really want to have to change it now. It's 20 past 2 in the afternoon. We're miles behind now. Doubt very much we'll make Lake Grayson 7 Miller's Hut. So we'll just see how we go. Don't know about you, but I'm ready for a beer. Yeah, we've got to get out of this country. Well, here's a turn up for the books. We actually go to Crest of Dune. Not a very big one, mind you, but a dune it is. Still all our friggin' spin effects everywhere. Just run off to the left.
Find his mate.
Yeah, both of them are there. Why's a silly bugger running parallel to the car? He's doing about 45 kilometres an hour. He's flying. Just backed off to see if I can get him on camera. He's now going away from the track. Unbelievable. These stupid animals. Well, I stopped here at Narry's Point. We're just about onto the Lake Racer Road now. I think we've got about 100 kilometres to get to 7 Miller's Camp, but when I got out of the car, I thought I could smell diesel. I thought Warren's jerry can on his roof's leaking a little. I was hoping it was going to be that, but then I noticed that I got a bit of diesel underneath the car. Don't know if you can see that. And then my worst fears have been realised. If you have a look at the angle of the auxiliary tank, the right hand mount has broken again. So it's definitely going to be a lay day if we get to Miller's Camp tonight, because I've got some maintenance that needs to be done. I'm going to need to ratchet strap that tank back up till I can get it home and go through the whole process of pulling the friggin' thing out to fix it again. So pissed off. All these aftermarket accessories just let me down all the time. Pain in the ass. We're probably about 50 k's from 7 Miller's Hut. Unfortunately, the sun's gone over the rise in front of us. Start getting dark soon.
will be in the hut in the dark, no doubt.
Sometimes I give myself the creeps. Sometimes my mind plays tricks on me. It all keeps adding up. I think I'm cracking up. Am I just paranoid?
And there's another tree across the road that you probably won't have a chance to break for, but I've just driven over the top of it at 30 k's. It wasn't a drama. Well, 10 to 7 in the evening and we've arrived at the Seven Miller's hut, or just about. We've hit the turn off for it anyway. There's the letterbox and the 40 kilometer school zone sign. I was going to say, according to my map, we're here, and lo and behold, we're here. Now, I think we're going to have to get a torch out and go have a look around to work out where we're going to camp up and everything for the night, eh?
Good morning. Welcome to Seven Miller's Hut. On the lake, on the banks of Lake Racen, which you can see out there. I'll go show you around. Neat little place. Sure, they have some spin effects everywhere. If you have a look down into the radiator, you can see it's all spin effects. So that's going to be a job and a half pulling all that out today. Bloody hell. Shit is everywhere. Well, here you go, folks. This is what 30 kilometers of spin effects without a blind does to you. Have a go at that. Now you know why I decided to spend a day on maintenance, eh? It's going to take me a day to clean this shit out. Unbelievable. Alrighty then. I'm a couple of hours in. They're pulling the whole car apart. I got my transmission radiator as clean as I can. I got half of the one side of the radiator as clean as I can. I've just pulled the thermo fan off. See what I got to deal with, but also see all the bits that we've had to pull apart just to get to where I am now. I've still got the intercooler to go after this, all the stuff underneath the tyre and the auxiliary tank. It's probably about 12 o'clock now, so it's going to be a big day. Welcome to the Pajero low mounted intercooler, which obviously isn't doing a lot of intercooling. This is taking us hours to do this job, but we don't really have a choice. Warren's going pretty hard, getting all the Spinifex stuff from out from under the bottom of his car. He's looking pretty knackered and pretty grubby and pretty spinifexed. Got bloody spinifex hanging out your hair and what a prick of a job.
This is a holiday.
Holiday? Not my idea of a holiday. And the hits just keep on coming. 8 o'clock in the morning, I go to start the car. I got no battery, I'm down to 10 volts. I'm hoping I haven't dropped a cell. So that's going to make it interesting for the rest of the day. 2 days to get home yet. What else is going
to
happen?
Well, we tried to get a relatively early start today. We probably would have been on the road at 8 o'clock until my battery decided it wasn't going to join the party, so that's probably just screwed an hour, so it's just gone 9 o'clock. There's about 8 of them, I think. Two of them were in the middle of the track, but they cleared out. see this single monolith coming up. It's not described on my map, but I'm pretty sure that that's Hahn's Rock, and up the top Frank Hahn has his inscription on it. I'm sure that's it. There you have it, folks, officially out of the desert, back into semi-civilization. We haven't seen a person for days. It's been bloody fantastic, but I guess all good things come to an end. Alright, don't need any assistance, you're right?
No, I think everyone's been called, yeah.
Okay, thanks. Well, that's gonna spoil your day. Certainly is the way to end a week in the desert. Out here in the gold fields, nice campfire, glass of red. Being so close to the road, we get to listen to all those juggernauts bloody belting down the highway. Don't know how much sleep we'll get tonight, but hey, what the hell.
My mind plays tricks on me. It all keeps heading.